I'm going to show you how to quickly and easily get these psychedelic visual backgrounds all in After Effects. So this look only uses two effects, no repeaters, and very few keyframes. So let's start in a new comp. And I'm just going to create a new solid with Control plus Y, and it doesn't matter the color. And let's go over and add the effect radio waves. And this creates a steady pulse of circles moving outwards. And we've also got quite a few options to control our shape up here as well. Now at the moment, it's actually set to a polygon, so it's not actually a circle. And if we go down to options, we can see it's a polygon with 64 sides. And if we lower that, you can see we can create more different shapes, sort of like octagons, pentagons, and even triangles as well. Let's go with 9 sides and create a 9-tagon. And we could also click to make this a star as well and adjust the depth of that star too, and the curviness as well. We can also choose to create our own shape using a mask. So we click our pen tool, and then I'm just going to draw a random shape over the top of this. And then from wave type, I'm going to select mask, and from mask, select mask 1. And now we're radiating in our custom shape. But let's go back to our polygon for now. Now we want our effect to start with these shapes already filling up our comp. So I'm just gonna go to the start and then drag this layer over to the left until it fills our screen and just keep extending it. There we go. And we can also go and adjust the frequency as well. So we get a more denser collection of these shapes right up until it becomes almost solid. And we can adjust the spin as well. So each shape that pops out will rotate slightly and we get a cool effect where they kind of bunch up and create these sort of almost 3D looking forms. So let's add some keyframes to these properties. I'm gonna do that by clicking on the stopwatch of our spin and maybe in our polygon, our star depth and curve size. And let's click U on our keyboard to bring up those in our timeline. And then over the start of our animation, let's animate these properties. So let's take our spin to something like -3. So it'll spin in the opposite direction. The depth to -0.2 and the curve size down to 0. So it starts really angular. And now if we play, we can see it animating between those two properties. Now remember, these keyframes are affecting the next shape to come out of the center. So it won't be until sometime after these keyframes that we can see those new properties affecting the majority of the shapes on our screen. But we can change that by selecting up here the parameters that set at birth to parameters that set at each frame. And then that affects all the shapes at once, which just gets a slightly different result as the whole scene's evolving rather than it evolving from the middle. We can also add a fade in time as well, which will make the center ones more opaque. And this creates kind of a look like we're looking down through a tunnel, which is really interesting if you want that. And then of course, we've got the options to change the color down here as well. So now let's get things really crazy by adding the effect CC Collider. And we can already see by just adding that, we're already upping the ante a fair bit. So what this is doing is it's taking a selection of our comp, copying it a whole bunch of times and flipping and mirroring it based on a few different options that we have down here. Now, if we pause the animation and let's go and just animate our center property here. So if we just click anywhere on our screen, we can see it takes the center of our animation from a different point. And if we just drag this around the screen, we can get some really crazy looks without any other animation. Now let's leave that here and let's actually adjust the size. And let's just bring that way up to maybe 75. And that just means that CC Collider will take a bigger section of our canvas before it sort of chops it up and spits it back out to us as a kaleidoscope. Now we can also change how it is mirrored. The default is flower setting, being try wheel and die across, and a whole bunch of different options. I do kind of like flower and starfish because we get this kind of radial symmetry, which I think is really interesting and kind of mimics this little sort of tunnel sort of shape that I really like. So let's go back to our center animation. Let's click the stopwatch to keyframe that. And I'm just gonna add a different keyframe in a random part of the composition at the beginning, at the middle, and then one at the end as well. Okay, this is looking pretty good. Now, if you didn't want these sort of squares in the corner, we could even increase the size even more so we just get this radial effect in the middle. Let's keep it like this for now. And now something else we can do is duplicate this layer. So I'm going to duplicate this layer, open up those keyframes and just move some of these around randomly. So now we've got two levels of madness happening one on top of another. Let's change the color of this top one to get a bit more variety. There we are. And we can also adjust the width of the strokes as well. And we have two options for the start width and the end width. So if we increase one, we can get a kind of tapered stroke as well. So the whole animation isn't a single line weight. Now, if you stack too many of these on top of one another, it can easily get out of control and the animation looks way busier than it's probably enjoyable. So, you know, enjoy responsibly, and stay hydrated. Let's remove this. I also experimented with adding the ripple effect, and that definitely adds a bit of liquid, watery feel to the whole animation, and kind of looks a fair bit like the Windows Media Player visualizers from back in Windows XP. I kind of prefer it without, but it's an interesting effect to add as well. And really, to create these and change them, it's just a matter of, you know, adjusting some of the keyframes. And you can see just adjusting one parameter slightly will affect the whole animation, and you can get some really interesting looks. So really, just go and try combining different elements of these effects and try some other effects in After Effects as well. And you can create some pretty crazy looking designs with loads of complexity just using two effects and without really knowing what you're doing. Here are a few more that I came up with, and you can check these out in more detail in the project file, which you can download for free down in the description.
I've made a short playlist of some related videos that I think you'll enjoy if you've made it this far. I'll see you in the next video, and please consider subscribing if you'd like more of these videos every week.